All right, let's play a game. Imagine you walk outside one night, expecting to see the usual calm, glowing moon hanging in the sky. But instead, it looks huge, like movie poster, doomsday level huge. Now, before you panic and start stocking up on canned food, let's ask a question. What if the moon really was closer? Would it just look cooler? Or would things go completely off the rails? Well, buckle up, because this is about to get wild. The moon, Earth's gravitational sidekick. First, a little background. The moon is currently about 384,000 kilometers, 238,855 miles, away from Earth. That's far, far enough that you could fit 30 Earths in the space between us. But this distance is no accident. It's a delicate balance of gravitational forces. Earth pulls on the moon, and the moon pulls on Earth, but they've reached a stable relationship, like two dance partners who have found the perfect distance to keep from tripping over each other. Now, what happens if we nudge the moon closer? Bigger moon, bigger tides. One of the first things we'd notice? The tides would go berserk. Right now, the moon's gravity is responsible for pulling Earth's oceans into giant, rolling tides. The closer the moon gets, the stronger its pull, and the bigger the tides become. If we brought the moon half its current distance, tides wouldn't just be twice as high. They would be 8 times as high. Think about that for a second. If a normal high tide is 1 meter, 3 feet, now you're looking at 8 meter, 26 foot, waves crashing into coastal cities. Forget beach vacations. Most of our coastlines would become completely unlivable. Cities like New York, Tokyo, and London would have to build massive seawalls just to survive. And if we brought the moon even closer, say goodbye to coastal civilization. Every beach would turn into an oceanic war zone, supercharged natural disasters. Now, as if megatides weren't bad enough, the moon also influences something else, Earth's crust. That's right, the moon doesn't just tug on our oceans, it tugs on the land too. Right now, the ground beneath your feet rises and falls by a few centimeters every day due to the moon's gravity. You don't notice it, but the planet is literally breathing thanks to the moon. But if the moon were much closer, that subtle movement could turn into disaster-level shifts. We'd see more earthquakes, as the moon's gravity stretches and squeezes Earth's crust like a stress ball. And let's not forget volcanoes. Some scientists think the moon's gravitational pull partially fuels volcanic activity. A closer moon might mean more eruptions, and not just little ones. Think supervolcano-level explosions that could alter the climate. Speaking of which, total climate chaos. The moon helps stabilize Earth's tilt, the reason we have seasons in the first place. If the moon were closer, its gravitational pull could mess with Earth's axial tilt, making our seasons more extreme. Summers would become boiling hot, winters would be brutally cold, and entire ecosystems could collapse under the rapid changes. And if the moon got way too close, Earth's tilt could wobble uncontrollably, throwing our climate into total chaos. One year, you might get 6 months of brutal winter followed by 6 months of desert heat. Good luck growing food in that nightmare. A jaw-dropping night sky. Now, let's pause for a second, because while everything I've said so far sounds apocalyptic, there would be at least one cool thing about a closer moon. It would look insanely huge in the sky. If we brought the moon to 100,000 kilometers away, about a quarter of its current distance, it would appear 4 times larger than it does now. Instead of a tiny, distant orb, you'd see an enormous celestial giant looming over the horizon, detailed enough to spot mountains and craters with your naked eye. It would be breathtaking. Of course, if you're still alive at this point, you'd also have to deal with constant tsunamis, earthquakes, and climate collapse, so maybe not worth the trade-off. Could the moon ever get that close? Now, you might be wondering, could this actually happen? Well, not naturally. In fact, the opposite is happening. The moon is slowly drifting away from Earth by about 3.8 centimeters, 1.5 inches, per year. Why? Tidal forces. Earth's rotation is gradually transferring energy to the moon, pushing it farther out into space over time. Millions of years from now, the moon will look smaller in the sky, and solar eclipses, where the moon perfectly covers the sun, won't happen anymore. But what if something forced the moon closer? Maybe a rogue planet swings by and nudges it inward. or some insane future civilization decides to attach giant rocket engines to the moon and drag it toward Earth. Either way, if the moon crosses a certain point called the Roche limit, Earth's gravity would rip it apart. Instead of a giant moon in the sky, we'd get a ring system like Saturn. It would look stunning. Until all that debris started raining down on Earth, triggering global destruction. So, should we be grateful that the moon is exactly where it is? Absolutely. It gives us stable tides, predictable seasons, and just the right amount of gravity without ruining our planet. If it were closer, Earth would be a chaotic mess of floods, earthquakes, and climate disasters. So next time you look up at the moon, take a moment to appreciate that it's at a safe distance. Because if it ever gets closer, we're in serious trouble. If you enjoyed this wild thought experiment, don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit that notification bell so you don't miss the next deep dive into absurd science. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.